Greetings and salutations, Exiles. I realized in my last video I didn't flesh out or summarize the fourth option. And I'm calling it the fourth option is because it's kind of what I came up with in the last video as a description for coming up with another server, official server variant. So right now we have three official server variants, and we really kind of need a fourth option, because as you get onto the servers, you'll notice that there are over 200 dead servers. Like, there are no population. There's nobody's playing on them. And with a fourth option, it could maybe create that synergy that it needs, to where you keep the player base around, because there needs to be a little bit of arco structural type where the players stay around. And there's a few issues or a few dynamics that exist in the world of Conan, and it really comes down to the player versus player environment can be so brutal that players get burned and then leave. You know, they do their 14 days of play. Like, I'm almost guaranteed that if they did some metrics on player lifespan or player, you know, and they go through about 14 days, they get to experience really only probably about 35% of the game. You're gonna probably get to level 45 or 50, and then what happens is they get raided, completely decimated, get pissed, and then leave the game. They're like, this shit's dumb, and they bounce. And they don't realize, because I say this because I've been through this. I've kind of gone full circle on this, and then I realized that is just a mechanic of the game. But for the majority of the players, I believe they just move on to another title, you know, like Black Ops or who knows, right? Fortnite or something that's a little less brutal. And then, you know, you have the player versus environment servers, where if they're fortunate enough to land on a server with a good community and fall into a clique within that first 2 weeks, then they'll stay playing on that server. But an issue that I've encountered is I enjoy a little bit of rogue versus rogue, you know, a little conflict. And if that doesn't exist, I typically get bored. And so this ties me back into the fourth option. With the fourth option, it's basically another variant of a player versus environment conflict server, because what I realized on the player versus environment conflict server is that it's still too sterile. There needs to be the option. Okay, this is the option set for the server, so the summarized option set. There needs to be the ability to all of your items, like fish traps, fireplaces, chests that are not purposely locked, anything that's like placed outside. So basically it has the same rule set as a player versus player server, but the only difference is there is no building structural damage. So it's kind of like you think about in four ticks. One extreme on the right is your pure PvP server. The extreme on the left is your PvE server. Well, you have your conflict that kind of sits in the middle. What I'm suggesting is you just have one more variant in there that is closer to the PvP server. And the only rule set that is changed from the PvP server is that, so there's 24-hour PvP, and everything is the same except as a PvP server, except there is no building damage. There is no building damage. And I think that would be the optimal environment. So you'd have 24-hour PvP. And if you don't want to PvP, you can always stay in your building. You can always stay in your hideout. And you can put your thralls. Your thralls, there's a reason to have thralls and animals at your hideout, because they protect you from getting killed. Or you just stay in the building. And on a pure PvP server, sometimes it can be brutal because staying in your building doesn't necessarily help you out, because this would blow your building up. You log in the next day and your building's gone. And so the player, the we're gonna call it gonna call it PvP conflict. And that is a lesser degree than PvP, and that way they keep the same name terminology, and it's kind of like, but I think that that would be enough to create that synergy of a positive community, but still create enough conflict and still keep as much of the game open, because the problem with PvE is a third of the game is pretty much deactivated to the player. Like, you think about this. Avatars have no role whatsoever. They're pretty much a dead asset in PvE. And so that needs to be brought into the fold to where, like, certain aspects of the game actually have purpose, and those assets and time that was used to create those assets is actually functional in that player versus environment role. So I'm calling it the fourth option, and I think if we gave it a name, we'd call it PvP conflict, and it would be everything the same as a PvP server, ex minus the building damage. You can't damage buildings, but it would be 24-hour PvP, and thralls would fight with you for 24 hours, and it wouldn't and the only difference is that they can't blow up your buildings, and that would fix the offline rating, and that would also, because a lot of times people get rated offline and they come log on and they're pissed and they just stop playing. And I would like to see more no ping servers added to the game. Anyways, if you like this kind of content, always like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.